Yes, good morning students. Welcome to the series of lesson number 13, Light, a Form of Energy. Yes, beta, in the previous video we have studied about what is light. Then we have studied about the sources of light. And in the next video we have studied how we are able to see the things. And we need both light as well as our eyes to see the things. And now today we will study about the letting light through, means ki from which materials light can pass, from which materials light can't pass. Today we will study about that. Yes beta, look at these. We have taken three types of container and we have kept these container on the table. And now see, these containers are of different materials. And what grandfather is saying to her, to his granddaughter. Grandfather is saying, look at these three containers. I have put a rubber toy inside each of them. Can you see the toys inside these containers? Yes, then granddaughter is saying, I can see clearly through the first container, partially in the second container and not at through the pink container. And then grandfather is asking, why can we not see through the pink container? And then she is unable to give the answer. Then grandfather is telling, beta, these containers are made of different materials and light can pass only through some materials and not through all the materials. So in this way, there are some materials through which light can pass, but what do you call the object through which light can pass? Yes, beta, the object through which light can pass are called transparent object. And now today you have to collect all the materials through which you can see. And you have to keep all the materials on the table. It means these are the transparent object through which we can see. Because light can pass through it, that is why we can see. Okay, and there are some examples of transparent object like glass, air. As you are watching, between you and me, air is present, but we both are able to see each other. That is why air is transparent. And water is also transparent. If you will throw any toy in the water, you are able to see that toy. It means water is also transparent object. So now beta, there are some material through which we can see but not clearly. Okay, now you have to collect those objects. Like you can take butter paper, you can see through dirty water, even plastic tumblers are there. And if you will see through them, then you are not able to see through them clearly. It means the object through which only some light can pass are called translucent object, And there are some materials, beta, through which you can't see anything. If I will keep a book between you and me, you are able to see me? No, you are not able to see my face, because book can't allow light to pass through them. It means book is an opaque object. If I will keep pillow in between you and me, you are not able to see my face. It means pillow is an opaque object. Table, cupboard, wooden door, these all are examples of opaque object. Okay, it means objects are of three kind through which light can pass. On the basis of this, you can say objects are of three kinds: transparent object, translucent object, and opaque object. And last, now beta, is shadow. How is shadow is formed? A shadow is formed when an opaque object come in between the light. A shadow is formed by an object which blocks the light completely or partially. If I will come in between the source of light, then my shadow will be formed. In this diagram, as you are able to see, that light is blocked by the palm tree. So the shadow of the palm tree is formed. Okay, how shadow is formed? When an opaque object comes in between the source of light, so shadow is formed. That's all from my side. Thank you. Have a nice day.